हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट न्यूमेरिकल बेस्ड ऑन एम्पिरिकल फार्मूला। इन स्टडी क्लास आई टोल्ड यू ऑल हाउ टू डिराइव एम्पिरिकल फार्मूला। आई टोल्ड यू ऑल मेथड्स, रूल एंड रेगुलेशन टू फाइंड आउट द एम्पिरिकल फार्मूला। ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द न्यूमेरिकल नंबर वन। It is given that find the empirical formula of the compounds with the following percentage composition. Percentage composition of elements are given. On the basis of that, we have to find out the empirical formula. Okay? So percentage composition of elements are magnesium. Magnesium percentage is given, it is 9.76. Then after, sulfur is present and its composition is 13.01. Then after, oxygen percentage is 26.01 and water molecule is present. Water means as a water of crystallization and its composition is 51.22, right? So percentage composition of different elements are given. On the basis of that, we have to find out the empirical formula. Okay, we all know to find out the empirical formula, we have to present a table. Table includes symbol of element. We have magnesium, sulfur, oxygen and water molecule. After symbol, we have to represent its percentage composition. 9.76 magnesium. Then after, sulfur is 13.01, oxygen is 26.01, water molecule is 52.11, right? After this, we have to write down in the next column atomic mass of respective element. Atomic mass of magnesium 24, sulfur 32, oxygen 16. Here water is not atom, so here we have to write down the molecular mass of water is 18, right? Clear? Next column is related to atomic ratio. Atomic ratio. Okay, how to find out atomic ratio? In previous class I told you all to find out, to calculate the atomic ratio, percentage composition of respective element is divided by its atomic mass. So atomic ratio of magnesium will be 9.76 divided by 24. After calculation, I'm not calculating here, already I have calculated, you can do at your home. After calculation, we will get its value is 0.406, right? Similarly, when we will find out the atomic ratio of sulfur, it will come again 0.406, means we will divide 13.01 by 32. In case of oxygen, this value will be divided by 16. After that, you will get 1.625 is the atomic ratio of oxygen. And finally, atomic ratio of water can be derived by dividing 52.11 by 18. Okay, and its value will be 2.84, right? We got the atomic ratio. Now after getting atomic ratio, simplest ratio is obtained. How simplest ratio is obtained? To find out the simplest ratio, we have to choose the smallest value from this atomic ratio. And smallest value is, or you can say smallest number is, this 0.046. Okay? After selecting this smallest value, other values will be divided by this smallest value, including the same number. Right? So 0.406 will be divided by 0.406. 0.406 by 0.406 value will be 1. So simplest ratio of magnesium 1. Sulfur again 1, because 0.406 will be divided by 1. Right? Again 1. In case of this 1.625, दिस विल बी डिवाइडेड बाई स्मॉलेस्ट वैल्यू 0.406 एंड इट विल बी इक्विवेलेंट टू 4. आफ्टर कैलकुलेशन यू विल गेट इट राइट almost 4. Then after water molecule, this 2.84 will be divided by 0.046 and its value will be approximately 7, right? Calculation you can do. We got the atomic ratio, simplest ratio, right? After this, if value is not in a whole number, we have to convert them into the whole number, because here already simplest ratio are in whole number, so that's why there is no need to convert them into the whole number. Okay, so finally we got the simplest ratio. Now this simplest ratio, these simplest ratio of different elements will be written as subscript to the respective element. First of all, we have to write down element. Magnesium is present, sulfur is present, oxygen is present, right? And water molecule is present at a water of crystallization, as a water of crystallization, right? So water of crystallization is 7. 7 will be written just before to this water. We cannot represent this 7 as a subscript. Okay, only subscript will be written with a different element. For magnesium, subscript will be 1. Sulfur, simplest ratio is 1, subscript 1. Oxygen simplest ratio is 4, subscript is 4. Finally, formula is what? Formula is MgSO4. MgSO4 dot 7S2O. So, empirical formula, we got magnesium sulfate heptahydrate. Okay, I hope you people understood. Again, we can revise it. You can see here, composition of different elements are given. Magnesium composition is given, right? Then after, sulfur composition is given, oxygen composition is given, water composition is given, right? On the basis of that, we have to find out the empirical formula. Okay, we made here table, symbol, percentage composition, atomic mass. After this, we calculated atomic ratio by dividing this percentage composition with the atomic mass of respective element, and we got the following values. After this step, we have to find out the simplest ratio. How you can get simplest ratio? From atomic ratio, we have to choose the smallest number, and from these, the smallest number is 0.406. 0.406 is the smallest number here, right? So 0.406 we taken the smallest number, including this number, other will be divided by this 0.406. After division, we got the simplest ratio 1147 for the respective element. Okay, now then after we written different symbols in the sequence, magnesium, sulfur, oxygen and water molecule. Now these simplest ratio will be written as a subscript to the respective element. Magnesium 1, sulfur 1, oxygen 4. And here 7 won't be written as a subscript, because water is acting as a water of crystallization. Okay, so we multiply this water with 7. Or you can say we put 7 as a stoichiometric coefficient. And finally we got the formula magnesium sulfate heptahydrate. I hope you people understood, right? Now come next numerical. Now come at next numerical. Next numerical is an organic compound has oxygen 26.24% and hydrogen 4.92%. Find its empirical formula. Again, I'm repeating, we have a numerical. An organic compound has oxygen 26.24% and hydrogen 4.92%. We have to find out the empirical formula. So let us start. Solution. Percentage composition of oxygen and hydrogen is given. Percentage composition of oxygen is given 26.24% and hydrogen is given 4.92%. 4.92%. Right? Only oxygen and hydrogen is given here. This is for hydrogen. Okay, we all know in organic compound carbon is also present. If carbon's percentage composition is not given, it is understood after adding the percentage composition of these two elements, it will be deducted by 100. It will be subtracted by 100. After subtraction, whatever you will get, that will be the percentage composition of carbon. So let's see the percentage composition of carbon will be equal to 100 minus addition of these percentage composition, 26.24 and 4.92%. Okay, when you will add, you will get 31.246, right now? 31.16. Clear? After subtracting this value from 100, the percentage composition of carbon will be 68.84 is the percentage composition of carbon. Right? We got the percentage composition of carbon. Hydrogen and oxygen already given. Let us make table. Okay, write the symbol. Carbon is present. Hydrogen is present. Oxygen is present. Write the composition of different element. Carbon 68.84%. Oxygen, hydrogen 4.92% as per the numerical. 92%. And oxygen is 26.24%. You can see here it is given, right? It is given that oxygen 26.24% I have written here. Then after hydrogen 4.92% written here, okay? And oxygen already written. Carbon is 68.84%, right? Then after we have to write atomic mass of different element. Carbon atomic mass is how much? Its atomic mass is 12. Hydrogen 1.08. Hydrogen is 1.08. Simply you can say 1. And oxygen is 16. Next step, I hope you people know. We have to find out the atomic ratio. How atomic ratio can be derived? By dividing the percentage composition with atomic mass. Okay, so this 68.84 will be divided by 12. After division, you will get value 5.74. Division you can do at your home. I'm not doing division here. 5.74. Right? Then after, hydrogen 4.92. Because after dividing by 1, value will be same. And for oxygen atom, 26.24 will be divided by 16, right? And value will become approximately 1.64. Clear? We got the atomic ratio of different element. For carbon, it is 5.74. For hydrogen, 4.92. And for oxygen, 1.64. Now we have to find out the simplest ratio. How simplest ratio is determined? First of all, we have to choose the smallest number from this atomic ratio. The smallest number is 1.64. It is how much? 1.64 is the smallest number. Clear? Okay. Now, after selecting a smallest number, including this number, other number will be divided by this smallest number. So 5.74 divided by 1.64, and you will get value 3.5. Clear? And when this 4.92 will be divided by 1.64, value will be approximately 3. This division you can do at your home. I'm not doing division here. Okay, 1.64 will be divided by 1.64 and value will come 1, right? Since this simplest ratio is not in whole number, so first of all we have to convert them into the whole number. How it can be converted into the whole number? By multiplying with 2. Because 3.5, when it will be multiplied by 2, value will come 7, right? 3.3 into 2, value will come 6. And 1 into 2, value will come 2. Right? So we got the whole number ratio. Right? Ratio in whole number. 7, 6 and 2. Now, put these whole number ratio as a subscript with respective element. Carbon, write down here. Write down the element carbon we have. hydrogen and oxygen, right? Whole number ratio for carbon is 7. For hydrogen it is 6. And for oxygen it is 2. So empirical formula is C7H6O2. Right? This is the right answer. Clear? I hope you people are understanding the numerical. Clear? So this is the way to determine the empirical formula. In the next video, we will discuss how molecular formula is obtained. How molecular formula is obtained. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.